बालाजी का
मैंगो फ्रॉम आंध्र प्रदेश, वी आर वेरी पॉपुलर मैंगो.
BJP had come out with a book against the EVM, Democracy in Danger. I mean, there was a hue and cry, all kind of allegations were made. As soon as I took over, I called an all-party meeting in October 2010, and where we wanted to know and understand from the political parties what exactly were the fears from the EVM. And in fact, my opening remarks were because Chandra Babaji was leading that delegation. I said, Chandra Babaji, it pains me to see you leading this delegation against EVM because you are a technology icon. And for me, the challenge is that to convert you into my brand ambassador for EVM. So, and then when we heard all these political parties, what was their objection? Of course, he led, and then we asked the other leaders. For Mr. Chautala, what is your objection to EVM? He said, whatever Chandra Babuji said. We asked Laluji, what is your objection? He said, whatever Chandra Babuji is doing. So the entire movement was actually intellectually led by Chandra Babuji. And in that meeting, it was decided that if we introduce VVPAT, this problem will be settled. We decided then and there in that meeting that okay, we'll go ahead with the VVPAT. We are the two factories to start designing, developing, and we are the committee of five independent IIT professors to start overseeing, and then the rest is history. July 2011, then we had done with many field trials, and we decided to do a full-fledged, full-day simulation exercise in five different cities. And you will, when I tell you those five cities, you will find a very interesting pattern there. Trivandrum, Jaisalmer, Leh, Delhi and Cherrapunji. All climatic zones were covered so that we see how these machines behave. There were lots of bugs, then we asked the factory to go back and then improve the design and come back. A year later, in exactly the same cities, exactly the same places, in the same month, so that we can compare the bill again. They worked very fine, and then immediately we ordered a manufacturer of 20,000 machines. Many people think that it is the Supreme Court which ordered it. Actually, Supreme Court in its judgment has complimented the Election Commission for all the steps they have already taken, and they ordered the Government of India instead that please do not stop the flow of funds to these people, whatever money they want, and give them the money. And they allowed, of course, we got allowed us to implement it in phases because manufacturing was to take some time, and that is how it happened. Therefore, if Chandra Babaji is leading this VVPAT thing, I have also written about it, although I feel very hesitant to comment on my successors because it is considered in a bad taste. But if we don't comment, who will? Who knows better the working of the Election Commission better than us? We have lived in it, we have worked in it for six years, we know every nuance of what goes on. Therefore, I do think this is something which should be discussed with an open mind, instead of just having decided that this is what we'll do with no prestige issue involved, because the Election Commission is the guardian of the process of free and fair election, and they should appear to be so also. I think we have a very defining week coming ahead. Because now one issue which is still undiscussed and undecided. Surprisingly, you have gone to court, sir, many times. But what you haven't discussed at all is what if there is discrepancy? Whether it is one machine or five, what if there is a discrepancy? That issue is still not decided. And that is where there will be confusion. And my suggestion is, without articulated the discussion of many, that if there is one discrepancy, the entire constituency should be counted. And now, of course, the Election Commission will say that, you know, it will take days, and it did not take 5 days when we had ballot papers. Ballot papers of the size of newspapers. It used to take a day, day and how will you take 5 days with 3x3 inch slip? So that of course is not a correct thing. And secondly, when the election commission has said, although some people in answer they are confused, that through the last 2 years, 1,500 machines have been counted, VVPATs have been counted, and they have all matched. There has not been a single mismatch. Therefore, my reassurance to the election commission would be that if this decision is taken, that if a mismatch is found, all the machines of the constituency will be counted. Don't be scared. It doesn't mean that it will take 5-7 days, because as you say, there will be no mismatch. Probably this will not happen. And if it happens in an extreme case, 1 or 2, 5 cases, the whole constituency will be counted. So be it. Why not? I would even go to the extent of saying that as the demand is that if there should be 100% count, in which case don't count the machine. Save you 10 hours of counting the machine, then go straight to the... And machine actually does not become irrelevant.
Yes.
Machine is generating the VVPAT.
Yes.
And therefore it's a very novel way of evolving your own model of India, that through the machine you generated VVPAT, and VVPAT is the paper which is counted, and that will take care of all the doubts for all times, and will be a global model. Thank you.
Generally, after VVPAT, the printer will print, then voter can take the slip, he can see which party he voted, then he will put in the ballot box. Sir, what I am saying, sir, think over, as on today, you are giving ballot paper. He is going inside and putting mark against his choice and then putting that in the ballot.
మా లేటెస్ట్ వీడియోస్ని చూడాలంటే కేఎస్ఆర్ ఆర్ఎక్స్ 100 టీవీ యూట్యూబ్ ఛానల్ని తప్పక సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి. అలానే పక్కనున్న బెల్ బటన్ని క్లిక్ చేసి నోటిఫికేషన్ని పొందండి.